Hey, how's it going, guys? Mr. Boss for the win here. And in today's Red Dead Redemption 2 video, I'm going to be showing you 15 must-know tips and tricks for being the best trader in Red Dead Online. So over the next couple of days, I'm going to be going over some more advanced tips and tricks for all three of the roles. For the trader, I have included a tips and tricks video in the description that I made about a day or two after the update came out. This is going to be going a little bit more in depth. So this is in no particular order, but at the number one spot today, a lot of people have been wondering, is it worth it to upgrade to the medium size and large size delivery wagons? And the answer is yes. However, you don't get to choose between which one you want. In order to get to the large delivery wagon, you have to have purchased the medium size delivery wagon. So it's kind of like Grand Theft Auto Online in the nightclub business where you can't just go from small deliveries to large. You also have to have the medium size wagon. So that's kind of where Rockstar gets you a little bit, is you have to end up buying both. And when you have both, you'll probably only end up using the large one. But that's just something to keep in mind there. Now, speaking of deliveries, let's talk about the total amount of value per goods and also how long it takes in order to produce those goods. So let's start with the value of each, since it is pretty much broken down into small, medium, and large. Small being 25, medium being 50, and large being 100. So from amount 1 to amount 25, each good is worth $2.50. So that means that if you sell locally, you're going to get $62.50. And if you sell at a distance, you'll get $78.12. And that takes 50 minutes to produce. So that's how much it is right there. From 25 to 50, your goods are worth $3. So if you deliver locally, it's $150. If you deliver at a distance, it's $187.50. And that actually takes 100 minutes to produce. And then from 50 goods to 99 goods, your amount is worth $4, and at 100, it ticks up to $5. So if you have a full set of supply at 100 goods, delivering locally will get you $500, and delivering at a distance is $625. And that takes 200 minutes to get all the way up to 100 goods. So you can see there that it really does pay to wait that little extra bit to get up to 100 goods. So if you're at like 75 or 80 or 90, just wait a little bit longer, because even going from 99 goods to 100 goods, it jumps from $396 up to $500. So it really is worth it to wait that little extra bit. And that's why it's also worth it to do the large wagon, so that you can end up getting that. Because if you just have the small wagon, you can only do 25 at a time. So you're going to be a little bit more limited. Now, a lot of you guys have been asking me what camp location is best, because this is really the only time we've seen in Red Dead Online and in GTA Online where your business center is mobile. Like in Grand Theft Auto Online, it would either take place in a warehouse or an office, and those are clearly not going to move. So with the trader, the thing you're trying to get the most is animals. And you can obviously move it around to get closer to the animals that you want to turn into materials. So my two favorite locations are the Heartlands right outside of Valentine, and also the Great Plains right outside of Blackwater. Now, I like these locations for a couple of reasons. Number one, they're close to big towns. So if I need to go to something like a general store or fast travel, I'm not that far away. But number two, this is where I like to capture the majority of the animals that I'm going to be turning in to Crips. Now, in the description of this video, I will leave a link to like a Google spreadsheet that has all the values of the various animal carcasses that you can bring to Crips. And it will show you which ones are worth it and which ones aren't worth it. And to me, the ones that are most common but also easiest to get are deers, bucks, pronghorns, and rams. And those are some of the best valued animals that you can turn into Crips. Now, there's clearly some that are higher. Like, for example, if you were to find a perfect cougar, that would get you a little bit of a higher amount than a deer or a buck. But obviously, those are a little bit harder to come by. Same with like a panther too. But those right there are pretty common animals that you'll find in the Great Plains and in the Heartlands you can very easily turn into Crips. Again, I will leave a link to a document in the description. It is incredibly easy. You can pull this up on your phone, a second monitor, and that way when you're sourcing materials, you can know which animals to look for. Now, building off of that, the efficiency perk, which is something you unlock as a trader, adds 25% to the price of perfect carcasses. So that means that if you turn in a perfect carcass, instead of getting 100% of its value, you'll get 125% of its value. So normally it takes about 28 and a half perfect deer that you have to turn into crypts in order to get 100 goods. Well, with that efficiency perks, that means you would only have to turn in about 23 deer. So you can see that it does make your life a lot easier while hunting as a trader. Now, also building off of that, one of the most useful things you can get as a trader is the hunting wagon. But you might wonder, what is the capacity of the hunting wagon? So the answer to that is either 10 small carcasses or 5 medium-sized carcasses, like a deer or a buck or a ram or a pronghorn, and then 50 pelts. So you can store a ton of pelts inside of here, and you can get up to 5 medium-sized carcasses. And that doesn't include the things you can still put on your horse. So the hunting wagon is separate to your personal horse, so you can have both of them out at the same time. So technically, you could get a few more on there if you really wanted to have like a huge take when you bring it back to Cripps. And another thing that's great about the hunting wagon that you might not have known about is that it can also store fish. So even though Cripps doesn't take fish, number one, there might be a future role that involves fishing because that's a popular part of Red Dead Online. But also number two, if you're still selling things to the butcher, which by the way, building off of that, you still should sell some things to the butcher, like that spreadsheet I talked about earlier. It'll actually show you which items you should bring to the butcher instead of turning into Cripps, because it might be more worth it to get some money directly from the butcher than a super low amount of materials for your trader. And also, one of the best parts about the hunting wagon is even if you leave Red Dead Online or you disconnect, the items inside of the wagon will be saved. So unlike your horse, where if you change sessions or if the server disconnects, you lose what's on the back, you will not lose what's inside of the wagon. Your cargo stays safe. And that, in my opinion, is awesome. Now, aside from materials, the other thing you need is supplies. And this is the one that you can either purchase from Cripps or you could actually do the supply runs yourself. Never purchase supplies. Now, this might be a hard habit to break because purchasing supplies was actually way worth it in GTA Online. But it's actually the opposite in Red Dead Online. It's completely not worth it at all. Do the supply missions, and you can do them every 25 goods that Cripps ends up producing. So just keep that in mind right there. Every 25, so basically 4 times you're going to need to do it if you want to get a full set of 100. And you also get a ton of trader XP for doing those missions as well. So even if they weren't great for being efficient, you still get a ton of XP for them also. Speaking of XP, another way you can get some good XP is by using some of the items that you unlock at your campsite as a trader. So that includes things like the weapon locker, which is already pretty efficient. It also includes the stew pot, which is kind of cool. I've been getting like a lot of gifts and items from Rockstar. Maybe it's because I'm a part of the Outlaw Pass program, but it's allowed me to create like these super unique stews. And every time you do, not only is it great for giving you gold cores, but you also get trader XP just for doing that as well. That's something I totally did not know about. And last but not least, I will leave another website in the description. This was created by Richard Westernra. Hopefully I'm pronouncing his last name correctly. He came up with an event schedule in Red Dead Online for the various role events that occur. And it's incredibly convenient. So I'll just give you a quick example of what I'm looking at right here. On the left-hand side, he's got the free roam schedule. And on the right-hand side, he has the role schedule. So you can see right now, at least when I'm recording this video, the manhunt event for the bounty hunters is going on. And then in about an hour, there's going to be another bounty hunter event. At 5:22 p.m., it's a salvage event. But at 6:52 for us traders, you can see that trade route is going to happen. So this gives you a better idea of when to expect events to occur and when you can be online to get involved with them, because not only does that give you a lot of XP, helps you rank up for the collectors, gets you a ton of items, for the traders, a lot of supplies. So these events that you can sign up for as a trader are incredibly lucrative. So it's something I would definitely take advantage of. But anyways, that's all the information that I've got for you guys in this video today. Hopefully you did enjoy, and hopefully these tips allow you to become a better trader in Red Dead Online. I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. Do you know of any other tips and tricks that you think people should be aware of? Let us know down there. If you guys did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would of course be awesome. And remember to subscribe if you guys are new. You want to stay up to date on all the latest Red Dead Redemption 2 and GTA videos that I'm doing here on my channel. And be sure to ring that notification bell as well. Sometimes YouTube just doesn't work, and if you ring that bell, you'll always be guaranteed to be notified when new videos arrive. But of course, as always, guys, thank you all so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.